everyone to the 2018 Energy Programs Training. The Low Income Home Energy Assistance Program, LIHEAP, helps keep families safe and healthy through initiatives that assist families with energy costs. This federally funded assistance manages costs associated with home energy bills, energy crises, weatherization, and energy-related minor home repairs. In North Carolina, there are three programs under LIHEAP. First, we have the Low Income Energy Assistance Program, also known as LEAP, which is available December the 1st through December the 31st for adults aged 60 and older and the disabled. In addition to the previously mentioned priority group, all other households have the opportunity to apply from January the 1st through March the 31st. Second, we have the Crisis Intervention Program, also known as CIP, which is available year-round. Both of these programs are administered through the local departments of social services. If your agency subcontracts LEAP or CIP services to other agencies, such as the Salvation Army, it is the responsibility of the county DSS agency to monitor the processing of these applications. Third, we have weatherization, which branches out into two sub-programs, Weatherization Assistance Program, known as WAP, which is available year-round, and Heating, Air Repair, and Replacement Program, also known as HARP, which is available year-round. Weatherization is administered through the Department of Environmental Quality. All programs are available until funds are exhausted. Now let's talk about the Low Income Energy Assistance Program, known as LEAP. The Low Income Energy Assistance Program, LEAP, provides a one-time annual payment to help pay the primary heating expense for households. December the 1st through December the 31st, applicants with household members aged 60 and older and/or disabled and receiving services through the Division of Aging and Adult Services can apply. All other households, in addition to those that could apply in December, can apply beginning January the 1st. Note that LEAP applications cannot be keyed into the NCFAS system prior to December the 1st. Households are considered vulnerable if its heating source is billed separately. Benefit amounts for this program are based on income, fuel type, and household size, and are given in increments of $200, $300, and $400. Note that applicants can reapply for LEAP if denied within the same fiscal year if their situation changes, such as a change in household income and/or the household size. Note, the primary heat source and electricity provider should be in each application along with the account numbers. This also applies to SIP. This is for federal reporting purposes, which we will discuss later in the presentation. This is located on the heat and electric vendor page of the energy application. If the source is not being paid, the worker should input the value of $0. For example, if the client heats with oil, the worker will enter the oil provider and the electricity provider on the heat and electric vendor page of the energy application. However, since the client's primary heating source is oil, the worker will enter a value of $0 for the electricity provider. This is important for federal reporting purposes, like I said, which we will discuss later in the presentation. Also, face-to-face interviews are not mandatory for either the LEAP or SIP program. However, interviewing face-to-face is often done as a best practice. The LEAP application will be available on ePass, allowing individuals to print the application, complete it, and either mail, fax, or drop it off at the local county DSS office for processing. As the LEAP season begins, know that outreach is a continuous process throughout all programs. Engage your community churches, doctor's offices, rural organizations, mental and public health agencies, private agencies and businesses, schools, and recreational centers to assist your agency in informing citizens of the programs offered. Now let's talk about the Crisis Intervention Program, also known as CIP. Applications are taken year-round or until funds are exhausted. Consider all factors when assessing a crisis, such as the outside temperature, household members' ages, and reported medical conditions. An energy crisis is defined as a household currently experiencing or in danger of experiencing a life-threatening or health-related emergency, and they have a disconnection notice or no heating or cooling source. This makes it a multi-layered assessment process. It is important to be consistent when assessing households. Applicants must also apply in the county in which they reside. Funds cannot pay bills in a deceased person or a minor child's name. If the bill is in a deceased person's or a child's name, encourage the client to have the bill switched into their name. Funds cannot be used to pay for water, sewage, or trash fees attached to the energy bill. Therefore, the applicant is responsible for paying the water, sewer, and/or trash portion of the energy bill before CIP funds can pay for the heating or cooling portion. There are also four additional non-federal CIP funding sources: Duke Energy Progress, Energy Neighbor, Piedmont Natural Gas, Share the Warmth, Wake Electric has the Wake Electric Roundup, and Haywood Electric, Helping Each Member Cope. These funds are available in select counties. NCFAS determines eligibility for these funds before using federal funds. Each program has unique criteria, which can be seen on the next slide. This slide breaks down each non-federal fund, the applicant requirements, the maximum benefit amount, heating source, and what the funds can and cannot be used for. I will not read this, however, we will pause here for a moment to give everyone a chance to read through this information. Weatherization is comprised of two sub-programs, Weatherization Assistance Program, WAP, and Heating and Air Repair and Replacement Program, known as HARP. These programs are available year-round. WAP assists with purchasing, installing materials such as insulation for ceilings, walls, and floors, caulking and weather stripping of doors and windows. HARP assists with tuning, repairing, or replacing heating and air systems. Both programs are administered by the Department of Environmental Quality, using LIHEAP funding. Programs are for low-income families, elderly, and disabled to make their home more energy efficient, reduce monthly utility bills, and provide a healthier living environment. Programs can assist both homeowners and renters. These programs could reduce future energy bills, which could ultimately eliminate the need for repeat energy assistance or decrease the amount of funding needed when in a crisis. North Carolina Community Action Agencies are contracted to provide the services, and the link on the screen will provide contact information as well as how to apply. Households containing a Native American adult aged 18 and older residing in Cumberland, Hoke, Robeson, and Scotland counties can apply for CIP and LEAP benefits. They must do so through the Lumbee Tribe. Households containing any enrolled member of the Eastern Band of Cherokee Indians living in the 5-county service area of Cherokee, Graham, Haywood, Jackson, and Swain counties may apply for CIP and LEAP benefits, must do so through the Eastern Band of Cherokee Indians. The Energy Programs Outreach Plan, the DSS 8119, was updated in June 2018. Counties are required to complete a local energy outreach plan annually and submit their plans each year to the state office for review. Collaboration and partnerships maximizes the success of our program. Stakeholders include, but are not limited to, vendors, housing authorities, public libraries, public schools and colleges, Head Start, legal services, Meals on Wheels, media, public health centers, churches, food banks, councils on aging and senior centers, community-based Native American organizations, volunteer programs, vocational rehab offices, and transportation services. Outreach committees should be formed and complete activities that target all households, especially the elderly, disabled, and families with children under 5 years old. The use of media outlets such as social media, newspapers, radio, television stations, and other print media such as magazine and the internet is also essential to the success of the program. This also includes media outlets in our Spanish-speaking communities. Be on the lookout for a Dare County Direct letter to be issued soon announcing press release packets for county youth. These tools will be beneficial to display in your agencies and share with stakeholders to display in their agency offices. The Energy Provider Agreement, the DSS 8163, must be signed annually by the vendor and local Department of Social Services and reviewed. There must be a beginning and an end date of 12 months on each agreement and should be maintained at the county level. The dates on the energy provider agreement must match the dates on the contract in NCPAS. If the agreement is altered with strike-throughs and or additional wording, void and complete a new agreement. Counties that opt to purchase bulk or single items must be entered as a vendor in NCPAS in order to be reimbursed. Note that vendors may be contacted by the state office at any time to provide data. Information support can be reached at 919-527-6270 or by email at dhhs.dss.automation@dhhs.nc.gov for assistance with provider enrollment. Review the job age, energy provider enrollment. County staff for further assistance with adding or correcting a vendor in NCPAS and how to contact DSS Automation. All energy applications must be keyed in NCPAS and every applicant must be given the right to apply at all times, regardless if funding is depleted or temperatures are mild. If the client comes in to apply for SIP, offer the household LEAP as well. This includes all households during the months of January through March and for the priority group December through March. This can be completed through a dual application in NCFAS. Remember, it's not up to the worker to decide whether or not to give the household credit to their account. If the household is eligible, offer those services and allow the system to determine approval or denial. Households must meet the eligibility criteria. Applicants may be eligible for both programs if they have at least one U.S. citizen or non-citizen who meets the eligibility criteria and meets the income test and are responsible for their cooling or heating costs. LEAP must have reserves at or below $2,250, and SIP must also have a life-threatening or health-related energy crisis. Ensure that caseworkers perform the four types of person searches in the system and or a energy benefit search to prevent duplication and over-issuance of benefits. Helpful job aids to review to assist in navigating through the application process are listed on the slide. The following steps outline the energy payment process. When the application is approved and authorized, a pledge payment is created. When creating a payment request and selecting pledged payment records to be sent to the county finance office, please remember only pledged payments for the same program can be in the same payment request. No more than 200 pledged payments can be included in one payment request packet. A payment request reference number is generated and the status is changed to submitted once the payment request is submitted. When the payment request is sent, the payments are issued directly to the vendor by the county finance office. The check number and date provided by county finance must be recorded in NCFAST. NCFAST updates the payment status to pledge payment issued. Remember, payment packets must be completed timely for accuracy and reporting purposes. Supervisors should check this information periodically to ensure no payments are missed. This is essential regardless if the vendor has been paid outside of the NCFAST system. Avoiding overpayments when completing a SIP application for oil or gas. After taking the application, enter the estimated amount approved for energy. Process and authorize the application. For example, the approval letter will generate showing the estimated amount of $300. When the invoice is received, put the application on a payment request. The adjusted amount will be deducted from the obligated amount and returned to the available funds balance. A new approval letter will generate showing the new approval amount. Edit the crisis amount on the application and confirm the changes. Note that when a vendor has been overpaid, the amount must be returned to the agency. When the refund is received from the vendor, the agency must return the funds to the county finance office for further processing. Document the refund amount received on the application. Applicants have the right to request a hearing if they do not agree with the decision made, such as the amount of the benefit or the time frame to determine eligibility. Information on how to request the hearing is found on the approval and denial notice the applicant received, the DSS 8107. Applicants have 60 calendar days from the notice date to request a hearing. Applicants who can establish good cause have until the 90th calendar day on the notice to request a hearing. This is found in Energy Manual Section 135. Local hearings must be held within 5 calendar days of the hearing request. For additional information concerning appeals and hearings, see Energy Manual Section 135. Now let's talk about management evaluation findings. Management evaluations are completed by the state in order to ensure compliance. These 4 points are things found during the management evaluation in the last year. Temperature alone is not the sole determining factor for crisis. Remember to consider all factors when assessing a crisis, such as the outside temperature, household members' ages, and reported medical conditions. Document all factors in relation to the crisis, including those listed on the slide. Counties did not meet the time frame for processing SIP and LEAP cases. LEAP applications must be processed within 2 business days of the receipt of the last verification. SIP, if the applicant has a disconnection notice, the application must be processed within 48 hours of the application date. If the applicant does not have a heating or cooling source, benefits must be authorized within 18 hours of the application date. Documentation must reflect the crisis for SIP applications. There is often not enough information to determine if there was a crisis. Counties must expand on reasons documented. Documentation is not concise and does not explain the actions taken by the worker. Documentation is not completed in a manner that explains the situation, nor is information transferred into NCFAST. Previously, we mentioned we would talk about federal reporting. Data is essential both internally and externally. The basis for all reporting is crucial to our business activities. In order for the division to gauge areas for improvement, data must be entered accurately. There are 2 federal reports that utilize the data that's entered into NCFAST and AR4CA, which is the Department of Environmental Quality Management System. These 2 reports are the Household Report and the Performance Data Form Report. The Household Report is necessary under the amendments to the LIHEAP statute enacted in 1994, which is Public Law 103-252, which states that grant applications must include a report on LIHEAP households for the previous federal fiscal year and requires states to report LIHEAP household data. The performance data form collects LIHEAP data on energy burden targeting, restoration of home energy service, and prevention of loss of home energy service. Remember that good data in always equals good data out. Therefore, everyone should ensure concise and accurate information is entered into the NCFAST system. Thank you for your attention during today's presentation. If counties have any further questions, they may submit them to the operational support team at dss.policy.questions@dhhs.nc.gov. Thank you.